Welcome back. You're listening to Nameless Nation. There we go. Whoa, ooh, whoa. I really like this mix. It's Selena and J Dilla combined, which is pretty funky. Great playlist. Great mix. So let's get it going. Trying to get comfortable here. I like the drum pad mouse, the drum mouse pad. So I want to do something with, there's a system in Maya that's pretty new. I'm like tied to a bunch of stuff. There we go. for texture baking. So, you can take details from one mesh and colors from one mesh and map it to another thing. Which is kind of what I wanted to do with this in Quixel, and we actually got that to work pretty well. But I can't remember if it was because I had like a duplicate of this mesh that was slightly larger, right? Assign existing material. Because I have all these weird colors, right? Matte ID, blue, green, yellow. Just give it that regular gray. Actually, let's make a new material. Because this is kind of going to jog my memory here. And that's just to show this, right? What we used to do is have a cage. And you still kind of need that. Which isn't unreasonable. Alright. So what I'm going to do is kind of stretch this object around that object. Which actually isn't that hard. Why is it snapping so much? Explain yourself. You're just outside of there. I could probably get a little closer on the top.
Taste of Honey.
here. Oh man, that's like my favorite beat. Wow. So I have baking settings. Let's delete that set. It's a classic. So what are we gonna map? So this is the same as that window. Okay. Song. Guys on point. How are you, chat? Present, absent, silent? Probably all the three. Let's go somewhere different. I'm so old, I could barely read this. It's a deep CFM. We got some people from our own zone here. Uploading stuff. I'm actually gonna come back and do the same. But let's listen to a new Grinfox track and work our way up. Cause it's a good place. Like I kind of wanna put carefully tuned songs up here, not of my normal style. Whenever I see a new online audio exchange type spot, I'm like, yeah, let's do that. The other side should be Discord. What are they doing? I do have an opinion on that. Let's see. Put out all of the things you can. Let's see what maps we generate with really basic settings. And it's a pretty low resolution map, so we have an input surface, we have an output surface, and one will inform the other, ideally. So let's try it. It's going to take a minute to process multiple frames. Wow, will we even see them? Looks like it rendered 20. Okay, well, show me what you got. So in D, my projects, I want to see... There's a turtle folder in here? Oh wow, targas, huh? Lots of targa files. Let's get PNGs. No offense. I feel like we're just gonna see 1,000 PNGs. Fake textures. Whatever FG maps, photon maps, PT maps, RC maps, temp stuff, texture cache. Okay. So let's do this process again. Let's see if we can find the setting for output. A team ad track. You know it. Man, I am. Here it is. Let's save this preset. Test all projections. Which we can actually make a lot of use of. We'll get into that in a second. The more I think about it. But let's do this again. Bake. Bake. There's like that map, and then it's done. Okay. So back in this folder. These are the maps that we get back. And this looks awesome. This is exactly what I expected and what I wanted. And it's really quick, because it's using your GPU to like make all these things happen. So let's figure out what's going on with these other things. So a specular map, we're not really... Our material that we're projecting doesn't actually have any specular information. But the mesh that we are communicating to does have tangent information. And a couple of things are happening here. This is pretty low res for one, but the quality is actually pretty good in terms of having a tangent space map. I can dig it. What else you got, man? Oh dear. There we go. Let's see. This is another thing that we really, really like, especially for Quixel to have a Matt ID. So now that I know how this works, I can take this to the next level. And is this illumination? Is this like an AO map? It looks like it's only lighting from a single side, like a top right or something. Top left. And then the beauty map, which is all that stuff combined. That composite with Maya's imaginary global light. So that's super sweet. All right. Well, we know that that works. We know how that works now. I was messing around with it the other day. In works that you cannot see, because we were just basically mapping IDs to higher res versions of this guy, right? Like, if we look at the mesh that we're dealing with here, we're talking about, you know, 2,500 triangles as opposed to whatever the heck we actually ended up with. And so let's do this, right? Let's take our super low res version and have that thing mapped up to the max. Because, whoa! All right, because that's gonna populate this folder again. Anyway. Because that looks a lot better as a mesh than our super mega one. I'm not sure about shared UVs. I haven't thought much about that. But hey, that actually might be an issue. Whatever. We're believing in ourselves today. So let's open another file. Recent files, arm light. Yeah, I'll save this one. For gallery. So this is the material IDs that I wanted there. As well as a bunch of curvature and other details and stuff of that nature. But if I pull up my low poly, this guy over here, let's duplicate you and remove you from this group. Group, I guess we could do this, bloop. And then do that. So I can hide you again. I have my own friend, thanks. Let's see, and I have two versions, yeah. The cool thing about this still is that I have kind of one mesh that I can target around the other mesh and get a lot of those details and colors projected onto this lower res model. So that's nice. Let's do it. Going from, what does that say? 35,000 to 2,500. Not bad. It's classic. There are a couple of mutations and some crazy things that were done between here and then. The cool news about that is we're not manipulating something that's too crazy. And so I kind of want to do the same thing and make maybe like a cage material. just so we can mess with the transparency. So I'll call it cage. And I'm just going to make it kind of hollow. And just take each piece, you know? Whoa. And squeeze around each of the other pieces. Give it a nice mesh-related hug. Because dimensions have changed as our design have just changed and all this other kind of stuff. T-Mad, with his mad, dreamy style. Hey, it's Tomoki. Thanks for being here for only a minute or so. I'm sorry if I've already missed you or you're leaving. But, it's kind of thinking about the world, trying to figure out how to process these wonderful requests from the community. I wonder if I can put all of these guys on a separate layer. That's like a template. Layer from selected. It's called layer one. Let's just make it a template layer. So I can't select it, but I can kind of move my dude around in it. That might work. Maybe render. But not select. Yeah. Just got that feeling. Just got the sickness. I got down with it. Try not to feel too down, though. I hope you're feeling well. Thanks, Tomoki. Take care, man. I hope you're well. I mean, that's the whole goal. That's the whole goal. I want to have fun with the stream too. So we're going to do that. I'm going to do it because you said so. How about that? Who do you think would win in a fight? T-Mad or Deadmau5? Can't possibly slow this computer down that much to run a smoothing operation. Besides, I'm only gonna render that thing. I'm not going to view it. Yeah, it's fine. It looks just so much better like that. Anyway. I don't know what other guys are around, but I'll see those guys when they get here. Do 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 do. Aha. This looks like an extrusion happened here. Me too. I made a lot of adjustments in the refining stage of these smashes. That's crazy. Also, kind of concerned about overlapping objects. This is neat. I have to log in to heart these things. I can't remember my credentials. It's like that bad dream that you always have. I was at the airport and I forgot my credentials. True story. To do with the orientation of that selection, but I still want a global, like I still want that. I don't know what's going on here, man. There we go. I've been thinking about winning. I've been thinking about success. Like, what are the things that I can succeed at, that I can own? Thank you. Hey, Tuk. How are you doing? Hopefully you've received a message. You know what I'm talking about. I'm working on projecting maps from one mesh onto another. Wow, there are like a lot of things different about these two meshes. One thing that I'm concerned about that I haven't really expressed is, see how not unwrapped that thing is? That drives me kind of nuts. Like, if I had just like the original, and this is the other thing. All right, so object mode, faces, I'd have to select every single face until I have every face on this island of faces, right? Looks like it's about that many, right? So, is it possible for me to duplicate this mesh? Wow, I'm so much faster than your computer. All right. And then reduce it. But more so than just this kind of method, yeah? Oh, this is already a separate mesh. Wait. Wait, there are two of them. That's a problem. All right, so. That's okay, we can deal with this. Face. Yup. Good. How are you otherwise, man? How is the life? It seems that progress on your game is good. I think I spoke with you about this like yesterday. So pardon me if I'm repetitive. But I don't think I streamed yesterday. Yesterday we did dog tracks to test out our new audio setup. Hopefully, our audio is super dope right now. As a matter of fact, I can almost guarantee it. I can darn near guarantee it. Separate out these meshes from each other. Leave no mesh behind. Well, here we go. I really like these exploded objects. Oh, excuse me. Is that it? Is that it, Deep Sea? You gonna play for me four tracks? Log in. What's my email address? Cool, what's my password? Wow, really? Sure. Does that mean I can listen to more music? Show me the latest music on Deep Sea FM. We just listened to it. Load more. Good. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Hey there, Slip. How's it going? So I was like mapping some meshes onto other meshes. Like, are these part of that layer? Actually, let's do this. Objects. Remove objects from layer, just in case. So, I was taking my low poly meshes and projecting my high poly meshes onto them. Doop, 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 doop. I was thinking, these low poly meshes don't have an unwrap. But the high ones do. So maybe I can decimate the high poly mesh, yeah? Couple ways to do it. I guess extract would be the way to go. Separate from the objects. Alright? Same thing with, like, this guy. I like the music that's happening over here at Deep Sea. I need to produce some. I'm going okay. Good sir, good sir. You were very polite, by the way. I think that's a great quality. But me, I'm a little bit under the weather. Been fighting it all week. It's kind of why Monday was a non-starter, as it's said. But we're getting through it. That's right. Boom. Extract. Floop. And I might actually have a whole bunch of different meshes now. Oh, there's one more in there. Ah, there's always a survivor. Also, I think there's one in here too. No? Good. I'm receiving vibrations from another dimension. My phone broke this week. Like, the screen broke. It works fine. Ugh. Yeah, everyone's just kind of feeling down. You know, the super virus is just kind of, you know. It's not doing anyone no good. So let's see what an operation like Decimate or Reduce, I think. It's like one of the cleanup operations. Let's see what that can do for us. If it isn't Steve out there. Huh. Yeah. Damn. Let's see. I like this genre, it's pretty cool. Is it under modifier or is it a mesh tool? What you could do is triangulate or quadrangulate. Reduce. What are my reduce options? Let's keep the original and give it a shot. Is that a lot fewer meshes than the original? It's hard to say. Like, what are you? You look the same to me. Separate, render, unite, extract. Yeah, but none of those things are this guy. What if I want it to be, reduce the number by percentage? I want 75% fewer triangles. Let's not keep the original this time. Apply. Aha! That time I definitely saw a difference. We're talking 1,000 faces for that piece? Not bad. Actually, that's a pretty good algorithm. It keeps... Yeah, that's nice. Okay, cool. Let's do it. It's a good setting. Let's save those settings. Well, the thing that I'm really concerned about is this. But check this out. It actually saves your unwrap. And it looks kind of busted, actually. Wow. There's no rest for the wicked. That's alright. It looks mostly good. I'd hate to see the distortion on this thing now, but... It actually goes a long way. So, let's try it with you. G? Ooh, open the UV editor. No, I want mesh. Reduce. Well. But these weeks are flying by. That means I must be having a good time. March was pretty intense. So I want to do that again. Sometime soon. Maybe next year we can have a March. Detach, mesh tools, crease, I was just looking at this, and now it has escaped me again. It's all right. I'm sitting kind of far away from my screen. Yeah. It's right there. It was under my nose the whole time. Oh, that's beautiful. Sweet. Poly reduced 3. Oh, it's just so good. It's so good that I have to just unilaterally apply it to this entire mesh because I really think that there's a future here. Oh, man. Yes, now it's 75% fewer polygons. Everyone can enjoy the benefits. Oh, this one has issues. How about you? I feel like you already experienced the wonder. What the... Maybe that's unnecessary. How many mesh... there is definitely a portion of this mesh that I... Yeah, let's do it. Yes! Goodbye! I really think that's cool. What else you got? You? You look like you haven't been reduced by much. Oh, that's great. You. Fair mesh thing. Let's just do that. Oh, yeah. It's less than 1,000. This guy. Totally reduced. Sweet. So I have an error with this mesh. There should be another round in here as well. Which may have been... Aha. I guess that's okay. Huh. So do I project these things individually? Or as a group? Because now I have my top one that I went back, right? Let's hide this guy. Because I think this method wasn't going to work. You can go back to being away as a group. Now this high poly layer cancel, and this low poly layer. I guess this is useful for if you want to make sure that your wireframes aren't the same. You can change the color of the wireframes, like this brown color. That's kind of neat, right? So I have like my high poly target. Oh, you didn't get reduced either. Oh crap, that's adding it to a layer. No, let's do that. Now it's like I remember the shape of the of the menu, but I don't remember the location of the object. Because there's, like, the first thing that I see is quadrangulate mesh. There we go. Woo 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 woo. Ooh, I like it. What, I can't heart this track myself? That's hot. That's a great track. Oof. All right, let's get to lining up. Because I think even now, we're going to see pretty reasonable maps. Definitely going to need a little bit of repair. But it's also not that bad. Don't mind it. Don't personally mind it. I don't want to see how it works out. See what we can fix. You know? You can't break these things, you know? Center pivot. Whoa, I really don't need to display normals, thanks. That's what that button's for. It's like, I know by default, these things are going to have a way closer relationship to each other. Just talking about space, like, we can get way close. The pivot is centered. We might even be able to bulge it up a bit. Because I think one of the errors that we get in our projection, like, let's say we are projecting this object onto that object, right? So, oh, that's another thing. I forgot to think about that. Let's select all of our newbies and give them that cage material. Go, 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 go. Same thing with you two. Even though you're pretty close. Boom. And then there's one more. But it's you? Cool. Yeah. Is if I have this mesh as my source and that mesh as my target. Let's go back to baking. Texture baking, turtle texture baking, options. This is great. Let's remove all. I have no idea how many surfaces there are. I need to cough, but I can't do it.
I can't.
Oh, maybe it's just Leon. Oh, everything's fine. Alright, so my source is gonna be this guy. Right? I guess I need my target first. So that'll be you, right? Right. And we're gonna test off projections. That's our basic preset. There's a lot going on, but one thing is gonna happen, and we can actually use, yeah, this iterative approach a lot. There should just be a button here, really, inside of this menu to bake. But whatever. I hate you. Look at that. It projects those colors onto those parts of the map. Yeah, now it's gonna waste a bunch of time. But otherwise, that's cool. Man, what is crapping up my... Hold on. Watch, it's gonna be some Windows game. Yo, tell me about that. Anyway, let's just go through here. 3D objects, I'm gonna tell me about it. Show me D Maya projects. I also really want to back up this project. For safety. Let's see. What am I doing? Well, I'm looking for a turtle. Fake textures. I don't need any of you cats. Is this thing not done doing its thing? Apparently not. Alright, do your thing. Oh, that's right, because it makes normals and a bunch of other cool stuff. That is super sweet. So that means for this entire object combined, we're talking like a 4K. You'd wonder, like, why didn't I just, like, I don't know, there's so many things. There's so many why didn't I just, but the problem with rendering is you're kind of half shooting in the dark anyway. Until you can tweak it down to the parameters that you think are perfect. So we're just gonna let that cook, which is not very exciting. DeepCFM is very exciting, though. I'm digging all of this stuff. It's like, they don't even, like, you don't even, do you follow people? Connections? Like, I like this dude. I also, there's somebody else that I really liked. This person before, e-government, was it? No, this isn't even the same. I'm so confused right now. This thing is playing, but what was playing before this? Because it's somewhere in this list, right? Like, there's like some trees. Is it you? Had this like wonderful high-pitched like back like sidechain thing. Nah. Yeah, I'm into that. Oh my gosh, Sophie finally showed up, man. Sophie, send me some music. I'm waiting for Maya to render some stuff. You know, which is like, I don't know, we did what we set out to do. We learned about how Turtle works, which actually isn't that complicated. I think we're gonna have to put in some kind of image-based lighting or sky sphere in order to get like a really good, like, ambient occlusion map. But the more information that we have going into Quixel, the better the result we're going to get from Quixel. And so, I'm glad that all this works. Let's get our computer to do something else while we wait. While you wait! Because the first thing I'm trying to figure out is, what the heck is taking up all this space on this machine? Like, I feel like there's a game or something installed on here. Oh, Unreal Editor. That's pretty big. 11 gigabytes. Maya has crashed. Okay, that's fun. Ugh. I'll come back to this. It's a good thing I didn't start up, like, Unreal or some other thing. Jesus. Alright. Totally fine. I'm really liking this, the quality of these songs over here, over on here. Let's go back to DeepCFM and scooch our way down. There's like a whole set by the ZVAD dude. Oh, it's because we're on that person's page. Oh, well, let's continue from there, I guess. I don't know anything about my account. I don't know anything about nothing. I've uploaded zilch. My icon's amazing. Shout out to the rhyme artist. Random. Just give me a random. Just random me. Yeah. Okay, so Unreal is installed. Some version of the editor. 414, it's an old version of the editor. 25 gigabytes, that takes up a lot of space. I could uninstall that and free that space up. Actually, that's probably the way to go. Because we're not using that version anymore. Sorry, dog. That was my fault. It looks like computer stuff. So what can I do with this? Let's delete. Yeah, we don't need either of these anymore. Delete. Delete. What? Favorite song, I think, the Bandcamp with some crazy Joshua something. Alright. Let's have a look at what you got. This one. It should be this one. Alright. Fragile hearts of an eloquent girl. Oh, cool. Nice. Let's follow this person. This person knows their sensibility. And outside of that, there isn't anything that really takes up that much space. There's probably a game or two installed on here. Steam apps, common. Steam VR. Okay, nothing insane. This is nice. So how did the interview go? I guess I'll have to find out in the next episode of Basil Tonic. Sophie, I was on Basil Tonic this week. I had a good old time. Do you know? Fortnite is updating. Who cares? Stop. Let's go to my lovely little playground. Yeah, it's so pretty here. Got all kinds of weird junk going on at the same time. I think I wanted to evaluate while we were like thinking about this. Was other materials that come with Unreal and what we can learn from them. Also, let's see, what the, I interviewed him, yes, okay. Have you heard of No Name Gypsy or Chelsea Rejects? I have not heard of either of these entities. Just saying. Dun dun. Alright, so I want to get something. Like, this is all leaning to making a proper couple of materials for this thing, which is sweet. Like, in the first level, we have this conveyor belt type of thing. And we're going to need something that, like, is all kinds of technical on the sides, but then has, like, some kind of sweet thing sliding through the middle, yeah? It's going to be a combination of materials, one sliding and one not, or one UV animation. What? This guy in my English class recommended them to me. They're female rappers. Great. We should, yeah. I don't know what the heck is playing now. Or that's the end of this song. Cool stuff. Really, really cool. Guitarist, composer, producer. Let's see what else you got. Show me your YouTube person. Oh, crap. BGM remixes, anime remixes, original music. Play all of your original music, person. I feel like we just listened to this. I'm interested in, I guess, the qualities of composed music in contrast to non-composers. Composer versus not composer. What's the difference? Tell me. Sophie, you interviewed a bunch of composers by now. What the is going on with my mouse? It's kind of stuck. Now it's fine. Okay. Anyway, materials. Did you know that I should probably do this on a new project? Crap. Okay, that's fine. Let's do that. Close you. Sorry. Save. Some Chocobo remix. This So there are Infinity Blade and Paragon assets that Unreal has released for free. For example, check a new project. Can I just preview this stuff? Do I have another vehicular? Let's open that. Create projects. No. Even though that is pretty cool. What does this mean? Okay, first of all, no. Select version. Okay, so let's put this on a different disk. I'm gonna add this to that project. Whoa. I just wanna add these scenes. An external project so we can download them. I have to mess with this download manager now. So Fortnite, like, I don't want to download you yet. It's supposed to be a good game. I don't know, people like Fortnite. I'm sure some cool updates going to that game too, but let's add this to that project as well. I'm just gonna preview a bunch of these assets and see. I don't like you. Thanks, man. Thought I could add that to a project, but gosh, these are huge. It's fine. So between rendering and crashing and downloading a ton of stuff, I have a lot to do. No Name Gypsy or Chelsea Rejects. Both of these sound familiar. What's going on? All right. Well, one of these tools has to be ready. I'm just feeling like sweaty and like coughing and dying. It's good. It's good. Gotta keep the heat up. Everything's so pleasant here. Where's that battery? Let's open this guy. Really? I made barrels? Cool. That's like an average barrel. Just go, man, just go. Up and racing. Cool sounds. What are your favorite songs by these people, Sophie? Oh crap. Now that we're here. Oh, I haven't listened to them yet either. No, I don't know who that is. How much information is inside of this project anyway? Let's copy it here, let's do it. Can't be that much. 26 gigabytes? What? Oh, it's saving out versions? Get out of here. That's not cool at all. I mean, it's very cool, but what? You guys. I feel very good, but also very confused. Send me some of the links. Okay, so we're just gonna have to divert our attention once again. I've been meaning to do this for a while, so let's grab this fresh oranges. By the way, have you checked out Took's recent geefs? Looks good. Looking good. Oh yeah. So let's download a couple of these Game Maker games. Yeah. What? I just want to download the thing. There should be more in here. I know there are at least two. Making something resembling art to get your ideas to real life. That's pretty good. Yeah, whatever. Thanks. Hey, Mario 1223. What's up? I'm going through our Discord, going through the Mint Potion Discord to test out. Any demos that are up here, whoever made a game, join me in the stream voice room. It's a good idea. I don't know where these people are now. Test it out. A world that people made in VR chat. That's interesting. What is this? Oh, okay, it's like a bathroom. Is it like an interactive bathroom? There's a lot going on in here. Let's get Hyper Engine 2 in here. I'm just downloading all these demos. I don't know how, if any of all these things will work. But it's fine. Nah, I just want to download the thing. Thanks, man. Demoing VR stuff. I gotta set up a VR thing here again. Working on a Game Maker Studio puzzle game at the moment. Sweet. I've got little to no experience with Game Maker Studio. I've made 1.5 lousy demos with it. But I have been researching it a bit here and there. It's just too many things at once, you know? I gotta find that thing. That thing that makes me special. And just, really focus down on that. I need to become a specialist in so few words. Straight up. So let's have a look. So I have a bunch of things downloaded. I'm moving a bunch of files. I'm installing a bunch of demo stuff from... gosh, what was the name of that game? Come on. I can remember this. Overwrite files. Yeah, just replace them. Just do it. From Paragon. Unreal's game that really didn't really work. I'm gonna add this all to the same project, and we're going to like have a look at how these tools work, or specifically what these like. What? No compatible projects. Then I will not add them. But adding art and maybe a character or two, because all of these assets are free to use. We should see if there's anything that we can take from Sci-Fi Hallway, for example, to add to Vehicular or whatever. I feel like something went really terribly wrong. And I guess I can open Sci-Fi Hallway now that it's here. But I want to try out some demos as well, and I guess there should be people here. This ain't bad. What ain't bad? Will this work? Will I have to install another version of the engine? Yeah, let's use 4.18. It's like the most recent version. I just want to see how dope the Sci-Fi Hallway is. Headset's not detected. That's fine, man. That's fine. It's like, you know, forget about it, bro. Just relax. I have a couple Game Maker demos to try out. We should definitely make a day of this. Like, have community gaming, the community edition, by playing all of the games that you guys are making. That I'm not opposed to in the least. I'm backing up a lot of my work. Apparently it's like 20 gigabytes of stuff. I don't feel super good about that. There's something going on there, but... you know. Better safe than never, or whatever. Loading. All this disk action could be, you know, sort of problematic. But hey, it's the future, whatever.
We should be able to open a thing. Yeah, we should definitely be able to open a thing and move a thing at the same time.
Could be wrong. Speaking of moving a thing and moving a thing, let's open this thing. At what point do you tell your computer, like, I'm sorry, dog. Windows protected your PC. Okay. Open anyway, dog. Open anyway. Just open it. Can you just tell me what's going on? Rain test exe and run anyway, man. Yeah, sure. Loading. Whoa. So here's rain test. This is a neat effect. Right? It's like, it doesn't make any noise or anything, but it's a pretty cool little thing. Did you see what Tuki put in the plug zone? I think it was the plug zone. I was just looking at Discord a second ago. What did he put in here? It's like Lumena showed up. Something is going on with all of the things. I don't know what you're talking about. I saw this gif that he put in game dev. I think it's maybe what you're talking about, Sophie. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Don't restore. Nice. This looks pretty cool. It's just a hallway. It seriously is nothing more than a hallway. Let's just load in a bunch of textures and stuff. It's gonna have to compile a couple hundred shaders. Yeah, that was the one. Yeah, it was this. We just actually talked about this. It was this guy. Is it Command K to go to game dev? I'm gonna go to game dev. Am I there now? Yeah, I was just poking through this to get the demos that I've been getting. So yeah, this thing. Yeah. It's like a lot of complex work, a lot of things to do. There's like an effect attached to an animation. Pardon me. I like this one a lot. The skeleton. Ah, so I spoiled it. But I think it looks great. Like that has a lot of bounce. It's hot. What was I gonna say? There's something about this. As these things compile, as we move forward. Who made the rain demo? Can I like search through this channel? Rain demo. Seriously? No results? All that trash for nothing? I know it's like within the last two or something thing. Rain test. So Dev Ed is messing around with weather effects in Game Maker 8, but actually looks good. So, you know, that's this thing, right? It runs pretty well, considering what else this computer is doing. Ah! There are still 200 shaders to compile. We'll come back to you. So what else do we have? I can't really read this. Something called Blue Sphere. Tell me more. Yeah. I agree. Oh, it has an installer. Okay. Let's install you on the D drive. Thanks, bro. Game Maker Studio. It looks more serious. So, Blue Sphere is a powered dog technique. I don't know if it's a full game or just an idea or a thing. But let's just try it out. Oh, that's cool. Does it work? I like the song. So we can change between the color types. I wonder, does this have like a puzzle mode? So Blue Sphere has a really weird rule. And I think that Paradog is recreating it relatively faithfully. Where, like, it catches your last input, so you can basically, like, if you press it fast enough, walk in, like, a circle. Do you have a jump, by chance? We won! We lost. I'm pressing all the demo stuff. I don't know what I'm doing. It's like hitting keys. It's cool. One thing I find is weird about like a lot of game. Hey, there's the jump button. A lot of test games. I'm just kind of looking them over, Atomic. I'm not particularly like. It seems like the things that are in game dev right now are just kind of demos and things that people are trying. But I'm also like moving a bunch of files and like. You know, waiting for shaders to compile and stuff. So here's a sci-fi hallway of one of the demos from Unreal. Looks pretty cool. We have to rebuild the lighting, might as well. While we're waiting. While you wait. Okay, so that shortcut key doesn't do what it's supposed to do anymore? That's exciting. Alright, so we have one more thing to install and test out. So yeah, but I'm looking at the stuff that people have posted in the last, like, couple of days on there. Like, the things that are testable. To see kind of what they are, and You want to allow this laptop? Oh gosh, it's still lighting build completed. Okay, thanks. Computer is actually probably really happy right now. Go, yes. I agree. Sure. You got it. Whoa, crap. No, wait, stop. Damn. Anyway. Let's start the hyper engine. Ah, so this looks like an actual demo that has consequences. I wonder how I can... So I can move left and right. I'm trying to figure out if I can jump. But this actually looks like there's a lot going on. Oh, there is a jump. It's over here. Okay. So, yeah, this is like a test of platformers with a one-way kind of thing. There's like this skid thing going on. I don't know if I can use this ladder. I can, but just go to a different room. Nope. And how do I get off this thing? I guess I have to walk. Interesting. Oh, there is a pause. That's cool. Alright. NES style game. Neat stuff. Neat and stuff. So our lighting is built. Let's like minimize this guy. Whenever you're ready. Not you. You. Thanks, man. Alright, if I hit play, you can see the fidelity of this engine's creator's stuff. Oh, we have the floating camera. So we got some good reflections that are simplified. Also these in-camera, like, what is that, bokeh effect? The bucket. Level before the next level. It's pretty good, multiple material. Very fine, scratched aluminum. This glass looks great, yeah. But it's good because, you know, most of the time you're looking at these meshes, the message that I'm getting is, oh, this poor bastard, is that you don't see them from very close up, right? And so what is the fidelity of this type of thing? It comes across incredibly well at a distance, but... Huh. Here are the pills. Place hands on the counter. I'm Corvin Dallas. What's this? There's some other room back here. So if I get out... Ooh. It's toggling rendering modes. Think of the Shift F1 to get control over this thing. Oops. Shift F1. And it shows us, like, the thing that we were possessing, that sphere, yeah. So this thing moves. That's cool. Just kind of goes back and forth and does its thing. Just gonna cheat a bit. Alright, that's exciting. So let's stop running the game. And have a look at what this is made out of. It's about decals. Ooh. Which are, I think, the text, right? This laboratory thing. And there must be a bunch of these guys. They do different things. Yeah. Okay, decals make sense. Atmospheric effects, and it's organized pretty well. It probably is also like a priority volumes, but also not too much crazy light going on. Let's look at any single object, something that's like kind of neat. Yeah, you've got like some different materials going on. Tell me about yourself, bench. Show in content browser. Could not find. Oh, the highway solution. What? Does this install all of these things? Ooh. Meshes. Buildings merged. Should be all blueprints. Oh, this is nice. Yes. Yes, this is what I wanted to look at. Of course, it's going to fetch it from the other side of the planet. But throw in your work in progress game, but it doesn't have any textures. So I'll wait a bit longer. That's absolutely cool. What is this? I don't know what that is. Well, if you choose to, Mario 12323, get on down. We have a multiple sub-object thing going on here. Nice. It's like just a building part. Not particularly complex, not too crazy. This is like the same thing over and over going on over here. Ooh, that's good to know. Not really like... Oof, why did I press that? I just wanted to see this. Very, very low poly. Low density. I can kind of read it if I change this back to normal. Let's see. Entire assets, about 2,300. Wait. 1,300 triangles. Ooh. Okay. It's like a combination of not very dense meshes. Slums, tin. You can look at each material. This doesn't look like it's particularly complex either. Like, where's... Like, this window probably is the most complex. So this is a material instance. Show me the mat. So I have a mask texture sample, which is taking information from one channel, and we're using that to make a mask. So we can take this color, even though this window texture is separate, we're going to take that color out. And multiplying the green channel with this green channel. It's a normal map. Oh, and I see we're changing this to a parameter where we can say what the instance of this thing looks like. Like whether or not there is light coming from this thing. So be emissive, blah, 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 you turn that on. And that says, oh, look, now these windows have lights on. So it's a scriptable material. Dope. All right. And now this instance has got lights, even though that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Pretty sweet. Let's see. But there are also rock assets, stairs, things. Yeah, it looks like a lot of... assets that probably were built out of other scenes that are repurposed. I want to see what scene this is actually from. Rock cliffs. I'm totally into this now. I should be investigating meshes all the time. Well, Mario, if you're in the Discord, which I think you are, feel free to send in your demo. And I will definitely make a date out of playing it. I think that there wasn't really much about it today. What are you looking at? Oh, 8,000 channels. This is a pretty versatile rock, though. I mean, it is supposed to be seen kind of from this one side. It's got a shape. It's kind of noisy. It's cool. Good stuff. I want to see what that stage looks like as well. I don't know at what level these things. See if I go to content, maps. Here's the main map. I don't know. I think this is the main map for the vehicle test. Oh, no. This is the science fiction room. That's not very interesting to me. I guess it would be in here. Soul City Mobile Slum Level Overview. Let's do it. But yeah, thank you very much. Especially when you're ready to. I mean, I'd like to know, it's difficult with game development to have something ready for a bunch of people to see at once. I mean, that's why these big events like PAX or GDC or whatever kind of have a lot of, what is this? Don't save. Hey, I know what this overview style is. So this is cool. This is actually something that we're also doing. Is going to build a nice little area for all of these meshes and stuff to live. We can test out to see if these things are actually coherent. Because we only need to build portions of walls, right? That's great, man. I'm glad all of this stuff exists. I'm happy to see this because I'm doing the same thing. And it's still a thing. That's cool. So you got tarps, you know, you got panels, just a couple of variations of that. And it's not, like, super crazy. Not even, like, in terms of normals, it's not super crazy. That's nice. It's good. But also, this is, like, mobile compatible and stuff. Like, they did a lot. This kind of, like, showpiece thing here. This looks good. It's like a boiler heater radiator thing. I don't know what it is. I like it. Wow, scaffolds. Everyone needs scaffolds. That pipe material looks wonderful. Actually, I want to check that out. Show me in your content browser. Three versions of these things. Look at this pipe material. Right? That must be it. And then they have different LODs for materials. Usually there's just the one. Look at that, though. I'm into that. Show me more. Nice. Okay, cool. Show me more. I mean, this is just the instance of the material, but I really think that that's great. What is this all about? Oh, it looks like they reuse this as well. Ah, and then they just spread the UVs of the part that they want across this measure. Because it's the same mat as this guy. I think. Huh. Cool, cool, cool. But not particularly complex. Not too crazy. I like it. Kind of have to make sculpting part of my workflow, I think. Ooh, it's like wet. How do you do it? So this is a pretty smart and useful thing to do. Show me in the content browser. Show me that material that's all squishy. Is it you? Nope. It's you. Yeah. Show me the original. Parent, physical material, previewing. Is it this guy? It's a great mat. Whoa, 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 whoa. Metal, rust, paint. There's a lot going on here. This could be a whole stream. I'm not kidding, check this out. Oh, wait, I see. This is like a physical-based rendering technique? Wow. Wet running water, wet intensity, it's a parameter. Yeah, so that anything, that's crazy. And these are going to be material functions that also... This is a very complex shader. Jeez. But I can see why. It's very widely used. Nope. I mean, if we were going to have the same stage in at night in the rain, right? Versus some daylight version. Like, you have some kind of weird weather cycle where your materials need these qualities. Yep. Neat. Neat, neat, neat. Vent modules. Cool. What are you? Looks like you're some kind of metal foundationy things. But look, it's all modules, and we can build a stage out of that. So for that stage, what are we looking at? Let's see, 8, 16... Not too bad. I guess we can count these things too. Like there. I guess if I just looked at SM, how many assets are returned? 187, roughly. I was going to say 200, so not bad. A static mesh. 200 assets per stage. This is a deeply interactive environment. Well, not completely interactive, but very reused. I don't even know what the stage actually looks like. I've never played Paragon. I think that's why these things are free. But that's pretty cool. Pretty stinking cool. There should be more levels. What's in here? Have a map for this. But I think it's also a mobile game. It's 200 assets. I mean, yeah, a lot of these things are the same-ish. There are many related items. None of the mechanics are told to you, and I'm hoping that the mechanics are intuitive enough to figure out on the first level. Okay. That's a good goal. It's a difficult thing to achieve in games, but it's a great thing to strive for. So... I say go for it. And I look forward to trying it out. Thank you so much for hanging out with us today. Stream is nearly done. We're not going to save the no light version of the... What the... What's with these shaders compile? This is cool. There's all kinds of weird stuff happening. But I love this, like, demo tarp thing. This weird, like... Vol. Like, what do you call this thing? Asset platform. Sure. It's just great to see how these things look next to each other. It's great to see so much. Like, if they all make sense. Like, my stage should definitely start to look more like this. Look at these lasers. Loving it. All right. A lot of things to do. Two beam emitters with this burst sprite thing. That's so cool. So much to learn. This is amazing. This is how you do it. Man. And there's like a fog effect in here as well. It's It's like some strange Pokemon Coliseum. Ah, yes. Used spiders or cockroaches. Other spiders, I guess. Interesting. They have at least three kinds of spiders. That's good. Smoke, little fires, big fires. A lot of these, I'm sure, are going to use the same texture, but look kind of different. That's good. These mesh-based effects. What? I guess there's something that is supposed to be here, right? Like, if you attack or something, or you get attacked. Different stages. Ah, oh, it's great. I'm into it. There's so much to learn. You've been hit, or everything is great. What are you? Is this animation? Yeah, it is. Initial location. Aha, aha, aha. But normal lava sprite. Okay. Same with this guy. That's an emitter that shoots an emitter. Also, this kind of stuff I always thought was super crazy, but looking at it now, it's not, you know, not too bad. I love it though, right? Like, what is this? Just something. This is an animated mesh. Yeah. Good stuff. Man, there's snow. So, I wonder if I can find all of these kinds of stages, right? What is this thing called again? I can barely see. It's some overview, something. Starter content, textures. Like, starter content doesn't really have an overview stage last time I checked. Main map. Yeah, we looked at that. Kite demo. What? Oh, you threw it on Discord. It's really simple but crazy. So, should I check it out before the stream ends or what? It's probably a little bit more exciting than me geeking out over all of these, all of this architecture. Neat. Don't save. Let's give it a shot. Shouldn't take more than a minute to beat the three stages. Alright, let's do it. What? Is not a commonly downloaded file. I'm gonna download it anyway, because I trust this stranger. How's my backup going? Hey, it's 90% complete. Rock on. Jeez, that took forever. Overwrite files. Always overwrite files. No. It's all right. I got your username. That's fine. So it's a co-op puzzle game? It's weird that Game Maker doesn't let you sign code. So you said I can move with the WASD. Can I move with the other guy as well? He moves with the arrow keys, it looks like. Okay. Oh, but I can't just, like, move to a place where I can't stand or hang, right? Like, that's the mechanic. Like, I can't jump really, but I can climb. That's kind of cool. Now, I'm not quite sure what the co-op part of this is, but let's work this out. Right, you can climb, not jump. Totally. Yeah, I got that pretty rapidly, actually. It worked really well. It's like, also the thing that's kind of disorienting to me on the first try is that your pink character and your blue character are flipped from each other. but maybe that's intentional, because then I could stand on the blue guy. But maybe I'll also be able to climb on the ceiling here. Like, I don't quite see the solution for that. Because I can't fall. Well, I can fall. But then how do I get to the top part? Like, do these two players, like, relate to each other? Like, do they have, like, some sort of symbiotic relationship kind of thing? Where, like, one is in one place and the other kind of, like, there isn't really any legibility on that. So that's probably not the case. But, let's see, what can I actually do? So I can't move. I can't jump. I like the idea of climbing, though. It's actually pretty clever. There's, like, a lot of options. There's a lot of opportunity for funny art about that. Like, you know, hanging on with your toes. What? Oh, I can jump from side to side. Oh. Okay. Sweet. So now we have to work together. Gotcha. So, I have to go back to start. Like, am I standing on Blue's fingers? Is that why this isn't working? I like that. I also like that you can kind of play it together. So obviously that wouldn't work, right? Okay, good. So I have to get Blue back over here. Like, hey man, I need your help. Oh, but they don't stand on top of each other. Interesting. I like how this isn't really easy to exploit. Squig 23, hello. I'm trying to beat the levels of Mario 123-23's game. It's actually pretty sweet. I'm trying to figure out some of the nuances of, like, why, for example, is it because I'm standing on this other character's, like, fingers, right? What rules are kind of legal? And how to cross this gap? That's kind of how it goes. Yeah, you squish their fingers. Hey, Link Waker, what's up? I'm testing out a game from chat right now. I don't know what it's called. But yeah, that makes sense. Like, that totally, like, good design. Good blocking. Good, literally, good blocking. I'm just trying to figure out how to not get screwed here. So yeah, he steps on their hands. I see that. I'm trying to figure out how to, like, close this gap. Or open this gap. Like, that makes sense. And then, I used to be able to jump that. That's kind of confusing to me. Right? But you can't leave somebody in midair. So now it's just utilizing the mechanics. Okay. So it's like, I need to stand on that guy's back. Right? But I can't, like, jump or anything. I can do this. But I don't have any, like, actual jump distance. Ah! That's pretty good. Well, good job with the mechanics. I mean, with animation, I think you'll be very, very clear about how this works. There is a type of circus act going on here. And I think that with co-op, that is going to be a lot of fun. Right? Interesting. Hmm. But well played. I really like what you're doing. I really like how your prototype works. Like, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, Link Waker. There's a good game happening here. Right? So like Pink needs to get over here and jump across. Totally fine. Gosh. Oh man. Okay. I think we got this. It's a good game. I'm into this. Go, man. Go you. Good work, Mario. Playing with two hands is kind of engaging as well. I kind of want to reverse their positions just to, like, not have the pains. Ugh, that is so weird. I mean, it makes sense, but it's just a weird rule that you don't have to, that you don't think about very often. Right? Because that's the way to do that. Ah! You go down, then if you go over and down, then you can jump over. Cool, right? So then it's like, hey man, get on my back. I press space bar, that restarts the stage. Okay. Oh, let's go. Okay. Yeah. Wait, don't hang over the edge first. That doesn't make a lot of sense. All right. Right. I should be able to get up without destroying my friend here or myself. That's not gonna cut it. Yeah, there's a lot going on there. I think the thing that's not immediately clear to me is, I don't know, you can get up, like, you just, like, you can't jump across here, but you can jump across here. things like that. If you can illustrate why that's kind of impossible, that would definitely help a lot, because the rule's kind of unclear, right? Like, is it because I'm on my toes? I don't know. And really, like, thematically, it doesn't take much to get that point across, right? Like, do I have to get them to move at the same time to achieve that? Like, otherwise I'm just going to be, like, stomping on my own face, right? Like, I can't really... It just seems counterintuitive. What? Oh, that's weird. Okay. We did it. Wow. Was that... That wasn't the third level? R... F1. Good game. I beat the game. That was still fun. Mario, thank you so much for the demo. That was cool as heck. You are the closer of the stream. As well as some wonderful tunes by... What the heck is this? Static Mesh? No. Not this guy. No. Whoever the heck just sent a link. It's probably Sophie. Ugh. This ain't bad. Wait, do I know Gypsy? Do I know No Name? I listened to No Name to death. Sophie. Alright, anyway. We're about to get copyright blocked for the last 5 minutes. Thank you guys so much for hanging out today. That was a lot of fun. Let's do game demo-y stuff. Let's do prototypes. I'm going to do a stream. Cranderson thought about this, called Bad Game Design Club. It doesn't have to be just about bad game design, but we're going to need tools for making really games really bad. So thank you guys so much. And good stream. You really are turning my week around. It's been a pleasure. Anyway, Show us your demos. Get into Discord. Everyone here is in Discord, clearly. And let's spread the love. I like what we're doing here. Peace.
Right up the